Welcome to Motivated Results. Today we will be doing a quick review. I know that's kind of the majority of the channel lately, but I am behind on these, so this is catch up. Today we'll be looking at my Ozeri food scale. And you're probably thinking, food scale review? Yeah, I thought I'd do it. Why not? I have two different sets of food scales. And so currently one I don't have in possession of at the exact moment. So I wanted to give you guys a review of this guy. Ozeri, I believe it's pronounced. Fancy looking. Anyways, let's go drop it in the kitchen and I kind of show you guys what it can do. Alright, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. So here's the Ozeri scale. Hopefully that's pronounced correctly. If you're curious about the actual functions of this bad boy, you have unit button, which will help you change units, whether it's grams, ounces, fluid ounces, whatever. You also have the power and tear button, and that's actually it. So, what you'll also notice is this is a glass top with plastic underside. With that being said, this does take two CR2032 batteries, some of you know these are probably pretty pricey. I mean, you're looking at about $4, give or take, per battery. And you need two of them, so you're essentially spending $8-$9 just to power your scale. They are essentially first provided when you purchase, but after that you will have to purchase them on your own. Now, the life of the batteries, I've only had to replace it once, and I did prematurely change them because of an issue that I'll explain to you here in a second or two. But for the most part, I've gone through two batteries in maybe 2-3 months. So once I get a little bit more use out of it, I'll definitely let you guys know. Another thing to note, let me put this back on, is that these guys are not stands. Since this is a glass top, so you can tell from here, so you tell this is a glass top, the glass, there's no way for the glass to actually move or drop down or anything in order to measure weight. And so that's where these guys come in. These actually press down to actually measure the weight of whatever's on top of the scale. With that being said, the issue I had with it is that if you have a dirty tabletop or countertop or whatever it is that you have, and there is something on these, because they do have a plastic, I don't know if you could tell, they do have a plastic bottom foregrip, they tend to grab dirt or specks of whatever you have laying around. And so, and essentially, if you have dirt or grime or whatever laying on these, it's going to make the scale unbalanced. And if the scale is unbalanced, your measurements will fluctuate, especially if you're using something like grams. Ounces, you might not notice it as much, but I've had the experience of trying to measure something with a dirty grip, and you do end up spending a lot of time trying to figure out why the scale is broken. So that's essentially why I switched out batteries in the beginning. So with that being said, just be careful with any dirt, any specks laying on them. You might want to just check it before you weigh something, which is a little bit of a pain in the ass, to be honest with you. But besides that, it's a good looking scale. I mean, I have no issues with it. Another positive is that it is black backlit. So you could essentially use this in the dark if you wanted to. It does have a unit of fluid ounces/pounds. Milliliters, grams, and back to fluid ounces. The tear feature works like any other scale. If you have a bowl and then you want to remove the bowl's weight, you tear, you wait till it zeroes out, and then now you know the weight of whatever you're trying to weigh. Simple enough. For the most part, that's my only complaint about the scale. Besides the fact that it is a glass top, so it does get dirty rather quickly, there is no other major complaints on my end. And even the complaint about the grime and the unevenness of it throwing off the weight, that, you know, in its sense, the only real way to do it with the glass top, because the glass essentially needs to be adhered to the plastic. So there's really no way to do anything more than that unless you take and get it, unless you get a different design altogether. If you guys are curious on how it turns off, you just essentially just hold it down, and there you go. All right, guys, I hope this has helped you on your decision, whether or not you decide to purchase this. It's up to you. I'll leave the description below in Amazon, because everybody really uses Amazon nowadays. And questions, comments, feel free to let me know, and we'll see you guys next time.